What's up? I'm Juan.
I'm Jackson.
Get ready for eKids.
Our VIPs first and foremost. What's up, VIPs?
What's up, VIPs?
Hey, guys. If you're new here, that means you're a VIP. Stick around. We got some instructions for you later, right? But Jerry, let's go ahead and remind the kids, what are we doing and where are we?
I'm making some burgers at a cookout.
That's right. We had so much fun last week. We're going to have another cookout this week. We love it. Got some chips. Got these giant tweezers ready to get the burgers off the grill. They're almost done here.
I'm better hurry up then.
That's right.
Well, if those burgers burn, I'm gonna be so mad.
But that's the thing, Jerry. They're not gonna burn, but we are gonna have enough patience to let them cook.
That's right. I know you like yours well done.
No, I don't. Don't spread that rumor, Jerry.
They're basically hockey pucks.
No, definitely not. I like a good burger that's not well done.
Yeah. All right. Okay. Liz, you like your burgers so well done, they're actually congratulations.
No.
That's how well done.
Okay. We got to keep going because the burgers are going to be done soon.
Okay. I know. All right, hurry up with the rules then.
All right, got it. We got to say our rules. We're going to do a speed round. Ready? What's the number one rule?
It is be respectful.
That's right. Be respectful, guys. What's the number two rule?
Be kind.
That's right. Number three?
Be a listener.
Yep. And number four?
Be helpful.
That's right, guys. We want to make sure we follow those rules so that we can have the most fun here today and be on our best behavior, right?
That's right. Exactly. Hey, speaking of being on good behavior, we got a guest coming in for some Bible trivia, so I gotta be on good behavior today.
That's right, guys. Let's get to it. Let's see what kind of Bible trivia that we're gonna have Juan do today. it's time for some Bible trivia. We've got Juan here. What's up, Juan? And we've got Jackson. Cheer for Jackson. Amazing. All right, guys, here's the dealio. I'm going to read a series of questions about the Bible. You guys are going to answer the question the best as you can. And kids, you guys are going to shout out what you think the answer is, and we're going to see who wins. You guys ready? Let's go. Question number one. Which book of the Bible tells us about the beginnings of the world?
I think I know. Genesis.
Correct! Great job. Question number two. Who were the first man and first woman?
Oh, I got it. Adam and Eve.
Correct! That's awesome! Question number three. There are 66 books in the Bible. How many of those books are in the New Testament?
Okay, I'll guess. I'm gonna say 27.
That's correct! Question number four. God inspired people to write the Bible. Who wrote more books of the Bible than any other person?
Moses.
Incorrect! Juan, do you know?
I'm gonna guess Peter.
Incorrect! Kids, what did you guys guess? The answer is Paul. Question number five. Which Old Testament book is a collection of hymns and songs?
Ooh, Psalms.
Correct! Great job!
Well, that was a lot of fun. How did you guys do? Let's head over to Liz to learn a little bit more about worship.
The Bible tells us in Psalm 34, His praise will always be on my lips. Wow, that tells us something really important about the word praise. We need to use our voice when we praise. You've probably heard that word before when we talk about worship, but did you know praise and worship are actually two different things? Yeah, when we tell God how amazing He is, when we thank Him for the good things He's done for us and all the incredible ways He's blessed us, that's what praise is. It's something we do with our voice. That can be through singing songs or praying out loud or even sharing with other people about what God has done for you. Isaiah 43:21 even tells us God made people so we could praise Him. So let's go ahead and practice that. Stand up on your feet as we get ready to sing and tell God how good He is.
I was searching for a better way, lost without a reason for the pain. But then you stepped right in and showed me grace. You found me, you found me. I can't get enough of you. You got my heart with everything you do. Now your love's making me new. You're the one I'm running to. Forever you're my reason. Gave my life a meaning. Got me singing through the night. High up and with love is. I won't stop for nothing. Got me dancing through. See my wrongs, but still I'm here.
Great job worshiping, everybody. You guys can go ahead and have a seat.
Story Lab's up next to show us more about what we're learning this week.
Welcome to Story Lab. This week we're talking about... patience.
Huh, I see what you did there.
Plus, some real fruit ninja action and the most expensive bowl of soup of all time.
Ooh, this intro is making me hungry.
Let's go. Hey, I'm Carter.
And I'm Zeke.
And today, we're talking about patience.
Which is waiting until later for what you want now.
Hey, Zeke, do you want a chocolate bar?
Of course. Wait. Is this some kind of trick question?
It is a trick question.
I knew it.
How so? Because you can have this chocolate bar now.
Okay.
Or...
oh, here comes the trick.
Or you can have an even bigger chocolate bar.
There's gotta be some catch. If
you wait until later.
Well, how big?
Can't say.
Ugh. Well, how long do I have to wait? I don't like waiting. Oh, you might even say...
here we go.
I have a weighty problem.
Well, here's the thing to remember. No one is making you wait. You really can have this chocolate bar now. It's totally up to you.
Okay, I'll wait. I mean, this is good, but if I hold out, I'll get something even better, right?
Yes, you will.
Okay, so, waiting.
Yep.
Just gonna do some good old-fashioned waiting.
Mm-hmm.
The old Wayne-a-Rooney.
Yep.
Whatchamacallit.
Mm-hmm.
Wayne McWaiterson.
That's right.
Just gonna keep on waiting.
Wanna blow up a watermelon?
That works. Let's do it!
To explode a watermelon, we'll need...
wait, no, let me guess. A watermelon?
Yep. I got one left over from my family's cookout.
Hey, watch this. Ding!
And rubber bands.
Oh. Ding!
Nope, more.
More?
Not yet.
What?
Yeah.
That is a lot of rubber bands.
Yeah, indeed. We'll need as many as 500 or even more.
And just for fun.
Now, we start putting on the rubber bands.
There goes the first one.
Oh yeah, we got many, many more to put on.
Ugh. Okay, so when do we get to the explosion part?
Well, when these rubber bands are stretched out, they contain potential energy. But when they eventually contract, what was potential will become real. That action is called kinetic energy.
Huh. So potential energy is stretched, and kinetic energy is
boom. Now, less talking, more rubber banding. Okay, that's 200 rubber bands. Time for a break?
Well, is it time for my chocolate bar?
No.
What about now?
Well, I just realized what this experiment is really about.
And what's that?
Patience.
Ugh, tricked into learning.
Hey, do you think it's starting to crack?
Ooh, ooh.
Right there.
No, it's just wishful thinking.
Huh. Well, I guess we gotta keep going. Let's go. Okay.
Yeah. Right on the center.
Yep. right? All right. Hey, wait a second. We're all out of rubber bands.
Hey, but you've got more rubber bands, right?
At the store.
You mean we can't finish?
You're gonna have to just wait a little longer.
No!
But while we wait, it's time for...
The Story Before the Story.
Today, we're in the book of Genesis, where it all began.
God created an amazing world, but people turned away from God and chose to go their own way.
God chose a man named Abraham and promised to bless the whole world through his family.
But this didn't happen right away. Abraham and his wife Sarah had to wait. And wait.
And wait. Finally, after years and years of waiting, Abraham's son Isaac was born.
And when Isaac grew up, he and his wife Rebecca also had to wait a long time for a family.
But at last, they had twin boys, Jacob and Esau.
And that is where our story starts.
Take it away.
Hey everyone, I'm Brian. In the book of Genesis, we meet twin brothers. Esau was born first, and he was very hairy. Minutes after Esau, Jacob was born, and he was very not hairy. Hey, do you have any brothers or sisters? Do you sometimes fight with them? Mm-hmm. Well, Esau and Jacob wrestled with each other before they were even born. And while these brothers may have had the same mom and dad, that's where their similarities ended. Esau was a hunter, which he may have learned from his dad. And there was nothing Esau loved more than being out in nature. The wilder and more dangerous, the better. Meanwhile, Jacob was just the opposite. He just preferred hanging out closer to home. In fact, he was his mom's favorite and became quite a chef. One son wild, the other one mild. So one day Jacob was cooking some stew outside the tent where his family lived when his hairy, dusty, and probably smelly brother Esau showed up. Now, Esau had been out hunting all day. He was hungry, he was angry, he was hangry.
Hey, bro, I am starving. Give me some of that red stew you're cooking up.
Oh, but not so fast, because while Esau smelled food, Jacob smelled an opportunity.
For real, I'm gonna literally die. I haven't eaten in hours. Give me some food.
You want some of this? This delicious, steaming, savory stew?
Bruh!
Okay, you can have this food, but only as a payment. You have to sell me your rights as firstborn.
Pause button. Rights as a firstborn? What does that mean? Well, at this time, the oldest son in a family was always given certain privileges that his younger brothers wouldn't get. Like getting the family's money and stuff when his father passed away. And the opportunity to eventually lead the family. It was a big deal. Something Esau had that Jacob wanted. In short, it was a really big deal. I mean, nothing you would ever sell for any price. And yet, it was also something a firstborn son would have to wait to enjoy. And Esau didn't want to wait. He was hungry right now. And so, he agreed to Jacob's offer.
Yeah, sure. I'll sell you my rights as firstborn. What good are they to me anyway? It's not like I can eat them if I literally die.
Now let's be real, Esau was not about to die of starvation. But Jacob gave Esau some lentil stew, and with that, Esau gave away his rights as the firstborn son. So was that the end of it? I mean, Esau just got a bad deal buying the world's most expensive bowl of lentil soup? Sadly, no. Because of Esau's impatience, many bad things happened, including a lot of fighting within the family. Esau wouldn't wait, and so he missed out on a lot of good things. The end.
Wow, that's a powerful lesson about waiting.
But also kinda, what's the word? A bummer.
Yeah, just think about how bad Esau must have felt once he finished that stew and realized what he had done.
It's true. A lot of bad things did follow Esau's choice, but guess what? Eventually the brothers made up, because no matter how impatient we get, God never gives up on us.
So, what's our part in the story?
Patience is waiting until later for what you want now. So when you think there's no way you can wait, like Esau, stop and think again.
Like when you have to wait for screen time until after you finish your homework or chores. You can get mad and yell at your mom and maybe completely lose your screen time.
Or you can take a deep breath and remember your mom probably put that rule in place to help you, even if it doesn't feel like it right now.
It can also be super hard to wait if dad says you can't have a snack because it's too close to dinner time.
Or to wait until your birthday to get something you really, really, really want now.
Exactly. That's what I do. Waiting is tough, but God promises to give us patience when we ask. When we follow Jesus, God sends the Holy Spirit to live inside us. Patience is a gift from God's Spirit.
And waiting time doesn't have to be wasted time.
Yeah, you could use that time to do something creative.
Or find a way to help someone out.
Yes and yes.
Well, I'm still not a huge fan of waiting, but I can see how God can help you wait.
That's great. We'll see you guys next time.
If you can wait that long.
So, here's the thing.
When you think you can't wait, think twice.
Now do we get to finally finish our watermelon explosions?
Still out of rubber bands, but I did put together this special montage to reward your patience. Oh.
That was awesome sauce! Hey, what's that sound? What's going on?
Remember how you chose to give this up and wait for something better?
Oh, right, yeah.
It's coming.
What's coming?
Your chocolate bar. Oh, right there's fine, right there's fine. Thank you. All right, see you guys next time. Thank you. Okay, here it is, your chocolate bar.
It's beautiful. So worth the wait.
Yeah. Thanks for joining us in the Story Lab.
See you next time.
This month, we're learning about patience. Waiting is something we all have to do. But the good news is we don't have to wait alone. God is always with us wherever we are when we wait. Did you know God has a special name that means the Lord is there? That name is Jehovah Shammah. You might remember a couple months ago that we learned about the name Yahweh, which is God's original name in Hebrew. When you translate the name Yahweh from Hebrew to English, it turns into Jehovah. So that's our name for God. But then what about the word Shammah? Sham is the Hebrew word for there. So when you say Jehovah Shammah, you're saying the Lord is there. Because God is always with us, we can always be patient. So if we're waiting in line, we can remember God is with us while we wait. If we're waiting for something good to happen, we can remember God wants us to think twice when we feel impatient. If we're waiting for something that we're worried about, we can remember what's true. Jehovah Shammah, God, is right there to give us courage and patience.
Whoa, that was such a cool Bible story.
Esau made a bad decision because he wasn't patient. Sometimes it's important to wait and think.
That's right, and we're gonna talk more about it right now because I got some friends to help us. It's group time. What's up, everybody? Hey, hey, say hey, guys.
Hey.
Hey, I'm Elizabeth.
I'm Grayson.
I'm Callie.
I'm Juan.
And it's group time. How do we do the song, guys? You wanna remind me?
Group time. Group time. And freeze.
Good job, you got it. You're gonna take it next time. That was great. That was awesome. Okay, guys, so it's group time. We're gonna get to talk about what we're learning today, which is patience, right? We know that patience is like whenever we wait on stuff, but obviously it's when we wait with like a good attitude, trusting in God, all that good stuff. So we are gonna open up with a fun icebreaker question, okay? And I'm gonna read it right here. It says, if you were at a cookout, which food would you choose to get a second serving of? Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and answer. For me, it's mac and cheese. I will get like 3 servings of mac and cheese. It's so good. What about you guys?
for me, it's probably a salad.
A salad. Okay, all right. You know what? He said health is important, which it is. Good job. All right, what about you, Kathy?
Mashed potatoes and gravy.
Oh, yeah, that's good. Do you like a lot of gravy or a little bit of gravy?
A lot of gravy because I like to mix it up.
Nice. Oh, okay. All right. What about you, Juan?
If there are potato wedges, I like potato wedges.
Okay. All right. Yeah. That sounds good, though. This is making me hungry. I'm excited for a cookout, guys. It's going to be good. All right. So let's get into these questions. Let's see. So remember, guys, we're learning about patience, right? Patience is when we wait on stuff and we deal with a good, cheery attitude because that's what the Bible tells us to do. Okay. So here's a question for you guys to think about. It says, what are some signs that you're about to lose patience? Ooh, what does that look like? What do you feel whenever you're like, you've been waiting and you're like, oh, I just can't wait anymore. What does that look like? How do you know?
I start arguing with people.
Interesting.
Okay. Yeah. What about you, Grace? What do you think?
I start banging my head on the wall.
Oh dear, don't do that. Makes sense. How about you, Warren? What do you think?
Start to get sweaty.
Oh, really? Okay. Sweaty. All right. Oh. That's right. Yep. Interesting. Yep. All right. So with that knowledge, why might it be helpful to know those signs? What do you think? Ooh. What do you think?
Maybe because we can like do something to have more patience about it, so we know that we're getting a little frustrated.
That's great. That's good to kind of like know yourself, and you know, like whenever you're getting a little frustrated, then like what do you do? What do you do whenever you get frustrated? What do you think?
You ask God to help you be patient.
Yes, that's great. Exactly. And that's part of the reason why we're talking about it today, so we can know what to do whenever we feel like we're getting impatient, right? Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to read. Actually, you know, I'm going to ask Juan if you want to read Genesis 25 verses 29 through 34. So these five verses are going to be about our story of Jacob and Esau.
Here it goes. Once when Jacob was cooking some stew, Esau came in front of the open country, famished. He said to Jacob, "Quick, let me have some of that red stew. I'm famished." This is why he was also called Edom. Jacob replied, "First, sell me your birthright." "Look, I'm about to die," Esau said. "What good is the birthright to me?" But Jacob said, "Swear to me first." So he swore an oath to him, selling his birthright to Jacob. Then Jacob gave Esau some bread and some lentil stew. He ate and drank and then got up and left. So Esau despised his birthright.
Whoa. Okay, guys, so Esau lost out big time in that moment, right? So what would have happened, you think, if he had chosen to be patient, right? What do you think?
Gotten the leftovers.
Yeah, he might not have lost out on such a big like blessing, right? So I know. So for us, what can we learn about like the importance of having patience? What might happen if we choose to have patience instead of just being upset or just going off of something really fast? What do you think? It's a pretty tough question. It's okay, we can think about it a second. What do you think it's important to have patience?
Would make better decisions.
Very good.
That's great.
That's very good. Exactly. I know. Okay, cool. So Juan, why don't you read our final question for us for the day?
All right. What are some situations you really want to do better at whenever it comes to waiting and thinking twice before you act?
That's good. So maybe like at school or at home.
Yeah. Especially because Callie just said you make better decisions when you're patient.
Exactly.
So what are some things that you can do, like you need to be patient at and make better decisions?
That's very good.
I mean, I'm a basketball player, so I would say basketball.
That's true. That's great. How can you be patient? Like doing basketball stuff, maybe, is it like with practicing or is it, what do you think?
Probably in the game, instead of just instantly going off to shoot it, you can think about it and pass more.
That's great. That's a really good example. I like that a lot. That's great, Grayson. What about you, Callie? What do you think?
In my drawing class, when we draw something, I don't want to be impulsive and just write down whatever, because, you know, art is, you have to be patient in your thoughts, and you don't want to do it too fast, because if you do that, it won't look as good as if you take your time.
That's great. That's really good.
I like that so much. So whenever we have patience, basically it's helpful for us if we're like learning a skill or trying to be better at a sport, all around, it's better to have patience, right? Amazing, so cool. All right, well, let's pray it out. Juan, wanna pray?
God, thank you so much for giving us patience. Help us in times when we feel like we're getting impatient to think twice. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, awesome job, guys.
What's up, everybody? My name is Ariel, and this is Jordan, and today we're going to be looking at this month's memory verse together. Memorizing a verse of scripture is one of the best ways for us to open up our Bibles and learn about God and how He wants us to live.
This month's verse is Psalms 27:14. Remember, all this month we're learning about patience, and this verse can help us remember that waiting is always worth it.
Psalms 27:14 says, "Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart, and wait for the Lord." This verse helps us understand that waiting for the Lord is wise. Being patient is always going to be worth it.
Definitely. And if we're going to memorize this verse, we need to be reading it often. We have a fun challenge that'll help. It's called Speed Say. Here's what you have to do. Have the verse in front of you and see how many times you can read it in 30 seconds. You can use a watch or a phone timer to count the seconds or have somebody keep track for you. Keep playing to try to beat your previous record.
All right, Jordan, I challenge you right now to see who can say it the most times in 30 seconds.
Okay. All right. You got the timer?
I got it ready.
30 seconds. All right. Let's do it.
3, 2, 1, go.
Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord.
Ten times. Ready?
1, 2, 3.
Wait for the Lord, be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord, be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord, be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord, be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord, be strong, take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord, be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord, be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord, be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord, be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord, be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord, be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord.
What?
You threw me off when you started counting.
Well,
whatever. That was 12 times. So
12?
Yep.
All right, it's game time. We'll see you next week.
Hey guys, welcome back. It's Shep
and Ashley
for Game Time. And today we are back with another round of Overcooked. Now, I've been practicing this game. I heard that we were playing this week, and so I really had to go home and make sure that all of my culinary knives, my culinary skills, yes. I almost took a culinary class in school, but
no,
I did not.
I watched a few YouTube videos. Anyway, we have a pirate ship, it looks like.
Oh,
I don't know what's
going
to happen on this map.
Yeah, this is the pirate ship one.
Let's do it.
I've never done this one before, but I think it'd be pretty cool.
All right, no fires.
Have you guys ever been on a pirate ship before? No, you haven't. Quit playing with me. All right.
Let's do it.
How do you start it?
Just hit the...
Which one? Oh.
I'm going to... All right.
All right, 3, 2, 1, go.
All right, I need onion.
Wait, where are the onions? There they are. Okay.
You have to
chop.
Okay.
I can chop.
No, you stay there. I'll hand them
to you. Yeah, hand them to me. I'll chop them up. I don't know what the chopping button is. Here we go. We got the chopping block. Here we go. Bam.
And then it goes in the pot.
Bam, chop the onion.
Oh, yes.
3 onions. We're making onion soup.
No, give me that onion.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm going to give you both of them at the same time. Here you go. Oh, you got to chop. You got to chop now. I got the tomatoes. I'm going to bring you 3 tomatoes. Oh my gosh, that's trash.
All right.
There we go.
All right.
We got a tomato.
Tomato.
Oh,
okay, if I can.
I believe in you. You got this. Oh, we have 6 tomatoes
right,
in the block.
Soup
we have
to is ready to
serve the soup. Made. Put it in the bowl. Great. Come grab one of these maters.
How do I give you that soup?
It has to come back.
Wait,
to
I have to take
it. Oh, you can go take it.
I gotta go.
Hurry. Okay, I'm gonna put this tomato soup in here. I'm gonna do the tomato soup, okay?
Okay.
Okay, I got one tomato soup. Here,
I'm gonna chop it up. Sorry, here I'll get you more tomatoes.
Yeah, give me some tomatoes. There we go. We got tomato soup.
Oh,
Guys, do you like eating tomato soup? Because me personally, I don't know. People used to put that with like toast and
grilled
stuff like
cheese
that.
Cheese and tomato soup?
Yo, is that a thing?
That
you used to do
best?
That?
Yes, I had it like a week ago.
That. Okay, you can serve that one right there. That one's going to come to you and serve. All right, so we've got one tomato soup going out right now. We've got another tomato soup going down. As soon as
Why
I actually
isn't
can.
It going in?
Oh, you have to give it to me.
Oh, yeah.
Here, here, here.
Okay,
put it over here. Put it over here. Put it over here.
Ah.
Okay. Can I throw these ingredients?
There you go. No. There you go.
I wish I could throw. Oh, I have to do that.
Okay. Drop that.
All right, there we go. We got a tomato soup going out the door right now. Now you're gonna be able to go ahead and sit.
Oh my goodness!
So you got one tomato.
Contamination.
It's don't on worry. The floor. Don't let anybody see it. Don't
I need
anybody
another
see
tomato.
It. All right, tomato.
You could chop this and hit.
I'll chop that tomato for you right now.
Thank
here we
so
go.
Much.
All right, chat. Listen.
It's gonna catch on fire very.
Oh,
soon.
Be careful. Put that in there ASAP.
Okay.
I'm gonna do an onion soup over here. I'm gonna get a nice little onion soup going.
I got you. I got you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yes, send the onions. Okay. Now we're gonna
oh,
need wait. Mushroom soups
we
next.
Need tomatoes again. Oh.
Oh, here you go.
Oh,
you're
not my tomatoes.
All right. All right, your tomatoes, get your soup plated. Get your soup plated. Okay. Get it plated. Where are
I
the
can't
plates?
Plate it. It's, you have to.
Oh, wait, okay. Put it over here. Put,
oh! Oh, no.
Oh, my goodness, my here, soup almost here. Got soup.
There you go. Just put it there.
Okay, putting right, it there.
I gotta get more plates.
Okay, grabbing this, plating this now. Gonna give you your soup pan back.
Go.
Wait, soup saucer? Is it called a saucer? All right, we're gonna go ahead and get this out the door.
I'm very
great.
Confused. What do we need? I need to. Here, cut that.
Chopping that now. Here
what
we go.
Do
chop,
I
chop,
do?
Chop, chop, chop. I'm gonna add this
oh,
to my
yeah,
pan.
Thank you.
There we go. I'm gonna chop this one here.
All right.
And then we're gonna do some mushrooms right after that. Here you go. Here you go. Here you go. Here you go. Put that one in there. Put that
just,
one in there.
I just threw it up.
Oh my goodness. And then we need okay. mushrooms. Ew. I don't know if who would eat mushroom
no,
soup.
No, 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 no. No, no, no. Here, here, here. Here. We're about to run out of time on the soup. Plate
okay.
It,
let me plate it. Let me plate it. Let me plate it. Let me plate it. Let me plate it.
Run.
Oh, it's going to you. You got to do it. You got to do it. You got to do it. You got
to
do it. That's all you.
You still have
to do it. Oh, I have to do it. I have to do it. I have to do it. There we go. Okay, we got a little bit of a tip here. Okay,
come on.
Now we're going to need some onion soup. So here you go. Here's onion.
Onion or mushroom? Oh, no. Onion.
Onion.
Chopping.
Onion.
Onion.
Onion. Okay, I'm going to take this onion. Go ahead and put it in the pot. There you go.
Onion
in the pot. You love to see it. Great teamwork. Rotating pot. Rotating pot. Here we go.
Here you go.
All right, here we go. I'm going to go ahead and get the. Okay, I'll get the chopping. Here we go, chop. I need mushrooms, 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 mush, 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 mush.
Mush, okay.
Mush, mush,
mush.
There's more mush. Oh, wait, stand by.
Oh.
I can't let this get on fire. Okay.
No, 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 okay. You need a plate for that when it's ready. So you might want to just grab the pot, take it to the plate.
Pot, the plate, plate, the pot. Where's the plate?
Yeah.
Oh, over there. Oh, it's already came back clean. Someone.
Ah.
Whoa. Who did that? Who did that? Who did that? Who did that? That's wild. Okay, okay. I need the mushroom. Can I get that mushroom actually?
Here, can you actually serve this?
Yeah, let me serve it. I gotta go take the mushroom off the thing.
Oh
my goodness, oh my goodness, oh my goodness, oh my goodness, I couldn't
put it in. Oh no, here.
Yeah, put that in there.
Yeah.
Okay, we got two.
Got
time's up, oh my goodness.
What do you think?
That was incredibly challenging. Now, I don't know about you, but I don't think soup takes that short amount of, we didn't even get a
star.
No stars.
Guys.
Chat, how we
did so
how
bad.
Did we literally get no stars? I feel like we were really finding our groove and figuring that one
I
out there.
Think one gold star was deserved.
Yeah, literally.
That is so sad.
Anyways, guys, well, I know we'll do better next time.
Yeah.
This was definitely one of our worst performances. However, ultimately, I think at the end of the day, we just really gotta lock it back in.
Yeah.
Next time, we'll make sure that we come in with our hats on right way. I think our hats are on backwards today.
Yeah.
And I think you might have had two left shoes on.
I did.
And and then there was soap all over the floor, so I was just sliding all over the place.
Suds everywhere.
Anyways, but we'll see you guys next time. Thanks so much for joining us for Game Time.
See ya.
Bye.
Wow, everybody. I had so much fun learning about patience today. And remember, we can always think twice when we think we can't wait. Okay, VIPs, if it was your first time here today, make sure you tell a grown-up in your house to click the link that's below this video. There's a link there just for them. All right, everybody, let's go ahead and pray. God, thank you so much that we're able to learn about patience today. Thank you that your name, Jehovah Shammah, helps us remember that you are always there with us while we wait. In Jesus' name, everybody said, amen. Great job today, everybody. Make sure you come back next week for a lot more fun at eKids.
Oh. Hey.
Hey, what's up?
I was wondering if I could borrow one of your serving spoons.
Serving spoon for what?
Today is the day of my annual family reunion.
cookout, and I need the spoon for my dish.
Oh.
Yeah, so it's a tradition that everyone brings their own dish that we can share with everyone. So it's kind of funny, though, because everyone brings something that kind of reflects something about them.
Oh, yeah? Like what?
Well, Uncle Ted, who's the shortest member of the family, he always brings shrimp. Oh, and Aunt Edna. Aunt Edna is the sweetest, kindest soul on earth. So she brings angel food.
Oh,
and Cousin Stu.
Brings stew.
No, he brings hard-boiled eggs because he smells kind of funny. Oh. My grandpa, Bill, works in the mining industry.
Yeah.
Get this.
What?
He always brings coleslaw. No, you get it?
Yeah.
Coleslaw.
Yeah. And what do you bring? Dry toast?
Hello, all you crazy so-and-so-ians out there. Welcome to the So-and-So Show. I am Brandon.
And I'm John.
I'm so excited. John is making his world-famous barbecued brisket. It is one of my favorite things to eat in this world. He's even won several barbecue competitions with his recipe.
Yep. 4 years in a row, I was voted best barbecuer in the tri-state area.
Really? Which states?
The tri-ones. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to set my trusty timer. You see, the secret ingredient to good barbecue isn't the spices or sauces. It's the amount of time you take to slow cook it.
Oh, for how long?
I can't share that info. It's classified by NASA.
Really?
No.
Oh, man. Oh, it already smells so good.
Oh, yeah.
And I am so hungry. Oh, I can smell it now. Oh, I am coming for you, you magnificent barbecue. I can't wait to have you in my tum-tums.
Not so fast. We have to wait for the timer to let us know when it's ready.
Right.
Yeah.
I see. Mm-hmm. So we just wait.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm. Sure, I can do that.
Okay.
I can wait.
Okay.
Come on. Come on. Come on, come on. Ah! 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 The alarm's going off! The alarm's going off!
Yes, I know. It's time to flip the brisket before I reset the alarm.
Reset the alarm?
Yeah. That was just the first hour of cooking. We got 7 more hours to go.
7 hours?
Hey.
Are you crazy? I'm hungry now.
Well, I don't know what to tell you. I can't control time, Brandon. Just grab a small snack or something to tide you over. Here we go. All right. Be right back.
Small snack, he says. Tide you over, he says. I want my barbecue now. Oh, I know just the snack. Barbecue chips. This might ease some cravings. I'll just eat one. Or two. Just two. Or four at a time. Oh, man.
What? Brandon, I said have a small snack.
I can't help it. I'm hungry.
Yeah, well, don't ruin your appetite, all right?
I promise I won't. I can just wait, right? I don't want to be too full to eat that brisket in 7 hours! Maybe just one more snack. Excuse me. Ah!
and great news. You know what that means? It's time for my brisket to be eaten.
No.
Brandon?
Yes.
Brandon, where? Oh, Brandon, what have you done? Oh. Whoa.
I had a snack.
Yeah, I can see that. So I guess that means you don't want to eat.
No! Don't say that word.
What word?
Ah.
Eat?
No! Oh,
okay. Well, I guess that means it's Bible story time with Kellen.
Hello, hello. What is up, my goodness?
Yeah, Brandon is a little full.
How much did you eat?
No!
He's a little sensitive to the word eat, to food, to words referring to edible items.
No!
Gotcha. Ironically, though, today's story is about a bowl of,
Well, then by all means, take it away.
Today's story is about two famous brothers, twin brothers, actually. Their names were Esau and Jacob. And even though they were twins, they were very different from each other. Esau, he was like the outdoorsy type. He liked to hunt and he was really hairy. And Jacob, well, he preferred staying at home and he was an amazing cook. So one day, what is going on?
Hey folks, now today, we dive into the volatile relationship between twin brothers who are more different than a wombat and a bag of corn nuts. Now one has swindled the other and we're gonna get to the bottom of how. Join me, won't you, for another episode of Dr. Larry. Okay, folks. Now the first twin you're gonna meet today is the slightly younger of the two brothers. Now please welcome to the show, Jacob. Hey, come on out here, Jacob. There he is. Well, hey, don't be nervous. Ain't gonna bite. Not too hard anyway. Have a seat there. All right, Jacob. Now, why don't you go ahead and tell me about the relationship you have with your brother, all that growing up and whatnot.
Well, we are very different, but we got along for the most part.
You got along.
Yeah.
You got a long. They got along, folks. Now that's like saying that dogs and cats get along. Or cats and mice get along, or pickles and tater tots.
Pickles and
That's what I'm saying, pickles and tater tots. I have it upon good authority, however, that the two of you actually had some heated moments. Heated moments that would make Tabasco sauce look like eye drops.
Ow.
That's what I'm saying. Ow, indeed. Now, there's a moment in particular that I'd like to chat about with you, okay?
Okay.
All right, then. Now, did you steal your brother's birthright? Did you steal your brother's birthright? You know, the birthright, the inheritance that he gets for being the firstborn. Tell me about it.
No.
No, you didn't.
No.
No, you didn't. No, you didn't. You didn't trick your brother out of his birthright for a bowl of stew.
Oh, that time.
Yes, that time.
Yeah, I did. But it was all his fault.
Oh. Well, there you go, folks. It was all his fault. Now, I'd like to hear a little bit more about that, but I'd like to hear it from your brother Esau himself.
Oh, my brothers here? How wonderful.
It is wonderful. And we'll get to see exactly what he says right after this very important commercial break.
So, yeah. Anyway, Jacob tricked Esau out of his birthright. And here's how it happened. Esau was out hunting while Jacob was cooking a delicious red stew. And after a long day, Esau was super hungry. So when Esau saw the stew, I guess we're going back to...
Well, now I'd like to hear this story from your brother's point of view. Hey, folks, Please welcome to the Dr. Larry Show, Esau.
Woo! Yeah! Woo. I love you.
Okay, Esau, have a seat there, buddy. I think you might be scaring my audience.
Thank you for having me on, Dr. Larry.
Oh, you betcha now. Woo! The tension's so thick you could cut it with the backbone of a stegosaurus. I tell you what, I can tell these fellas are twins. I mean, it's like looking at two mirror images. That is if those mirrors were facing completely different people.
Thank you.
Now, Esau, Jacob here says he didn't steal any kind of birthright from you. Now, what says you about that?
He tricked me.
Oh, there you go. Your lies smell like a pound of head cheese.
But.
Interjection here.
He didn't steal it. Mm-hmm. I gave it to him.
What? Whoa! I did not see that coming, folks. Hoo-hoo! I'm about as lost as last year's Easter egg. I think I'm gonna need a breather here. We'll be right back.
Ooh, a twist. So when Esau saw his brother stew, he really wanted a bowl. Like, he really wanted a bowl. And Jacob knew it. So Jacob decided to offer a trade, a bowl of stew for Esau's. That was so close.
Well, folks, I'm as flabbergasted as a bowl full of flubber in a shake and bake commercial. Now, Esau, can you repeat what you just said before we went to break?
I said I gave Jacob my birthright.
Well, I guess my question is probably the same thing that everybody out there in TV land is thinking, and here it is. Huh?
I was hungry, okay? I thought I was gonna die if I didn't get food. Couldn't wait, I got so impatient. And Jacob offered me a bowl of stew for my...
His birthright?
And you just up and said yes, all Willie Nelson-like.
Well, I wasn't sure if he was actually gonna go for it. I mean, a birthright for stew? That has to be one of the most understandable decisions I've ever seen.
Well, I for one think you both ought to be ashamed of yourself. You, Jacob, for taking advantage of your starving brother. And you, Esau, for being so impatient that you traded away everything for a bowl of stew. Folks, this reminds me of something my uncle would say. If you can't look a gift horse in the mouth, you might as well play the banjo. Think on it. There you go. So, what have we learned here today? Simple. Impatient. Don't be it. That's all the time we've got today. Hey, won't you join me next time for another heaping helping of Dr. Larry? All right then, folks. Well done. I appreciate that. Hey, let's go grab something to eat.
Well, there you have it. Jacob's brother Esau gave up his entire inheritance for a bowl of stew. Yikes. His impatience cost him, well, everything. What'd you think, fellas?
Listen, I've been impatient before, but I've never done something that ridiculous.
I'm sure I've made some really bad decisions because I couldn't wait.
Hey, we all have. And we all know that when we are not patient, we can miss out on something valuable. That is why it's so important for us to ask God to help us when we think we just can't wait.
Why did I snack so much?
Thanks for the story.
No problem, and feel better.
Bye. You gonna be all right, buddy? I mean, you ate a lot.
No! But yeah, I'm just bummed I didn't get a chance to experience your prize-winning brisket.
Yeah, me too. But you know what? You can experience.
Yep. Reveal the question.
Oh, what could you miss out on by not waiting? Well, there's...
Brisket.
Yep. Watching spoilers might make you miss out on the ending of your favorite movie or TV show. Or, you know, you may miss out on something else. You know?
Like brisket?
Well, or... Yeah, something a little more important. Yeah, just listen, talk about it together. What could you miss out on by not waiting? That's all the time we have. I'm John.
I'm Brisket.
Yeah, we'll see you on the next So-and-So Show.